Okay, I'm having an issue with my truck. Can't get my truck started. Somebody new made the starter, I think. It just clicks. I tried jumping and stuff, and it's not doing really too much, so I'm gonna put this stuff here for now. So I figure out what I'm gonna do. I'm taking this other vehicle. I was gonna dump this, but I figured, you know, don't have a lot here. But I need this truck tomorrow to do that job. The one we seen yesterday where we're stripping out that garage, the walls, the garage and stuff. So I need to have a vehicle. I can still take the garbage with this either way. I think I might have to take my truck to a shop. Put this on the bin right away, I think. A few things I want to process here. I got a fridge, well, I don't care about fridge, just the hot water tank, maybe a dishwasher. I'm thinking, but I can put a hot water tank in the other bathtub in here, and then that garbage on top. Just have my bin full. Anyways, it's always like that, you know, something goes one thing or the other, right? I know my starter before used to kind of kick out, you know how it kicks out and makes that weird noise? Did that a few times before, but just don't know. Something's clicking there, like it sounds like it's ready to click in, but it doesn't turn, so that's too bad. These bathtubs are actual pain to deal with. But I'm thinking of maybe taking a load today, or some stuff to use in yard, I'm thinking, just because, you know, just taking my garage up too much to get rid of those carburetors and different things. See, I think there's probably half decent mortar in this thing, but I don't know. We'll flip it and see in a second. The stove is actually probably good. Well, it's beat up looking, but it probably works. Yeah, it's good mortar. Could be copper. Huh. Someone cut the wires. Well, the wires are off. Cut. Huh, weird. That was the one I got from the house. They cut the wires here, but they never took the cord. How stupid are these guys? Stupid, huh? I'm gonna see if that's a copper mortar. I'm gonna take it off. Let me get the next bathtub. Sounds like there's something in a dishwasher too, like it could be full of junk, I don't know. I'll have to look at it before I dump it. It's a big hot water tank too, that one. Looks like aluminum can on the bottom. That one bike is aluminum too. That blue one's aluminum. Oh. See, I was thinking if I dump this, it's only 20 bucks anyways, no big deal. Not gonna give me any more money than I have, so. We've processed it. This is a heavy tub. It's got a lot of weight to it. Some of these are light, but this one's pretty heavy. I'll get my hot water tank in here. I mean, it's close. Okay, we'll see what I can do. I'll take the copper off the top and that metal pan on the bottom. Okay. A little closer. There. I'll take the side valve off the two top valves. Since it's electric, I'll pull the wire off the side from the bottom to the top. I'll show you. Wire. Okay. If I turn around, maybe I could fit it between or something. Or I could put the hot water tank in first and then maybe the bathtub we'll figure out. Okay. The aluminum pan. Actually, maybe not, looks like aluminum. I think it is, but sometimes you have a real light duty, like a tin, light gauge. Okay, let me get my stuff ready here. Let's take this mortar off, take this, even that mortar, I don't really care, but let me just pull this wire out, hopefully I can pull it out. See, maybe not, we'll try, but I'll take these off anyways, so stand by. Okay, so I scratched this one, it's aluminum. Looks like aluminum. It almost looks like copper from here. See, sometimes it's hard to tell. I think you need to file, it's probably the best. Okay, let's pull this off here. so it goes down to go off. Even if you take this off, it's not clean. There's a spring in there and all kinds of stuff. Plastic spring and so on, but you know, they usually pay $1 a pound for this dirty like that. Sometimes it's easier just to sell it the way it is, just because, you know, if you have to go through grinder blades, it costs money, right? You don't realize, I mean, you pay $1, $2 for a blade, maybe. Tiny there. Yeah, there it is. I'd say that's the way. Yeah. See, it doesn't seem like much, but you know, you start adding this stuff, you'll have a bucket in no time. So it's worth taking. Okay, so right away you got clean copper here. It's still number two because it's got solder, dirty brass. You can cut this off here, right? Some guys will cut it here or something, right? But you know, you probably have to cut it in a way. Somebody had a video on YouTube was pretty good about taking those off, but I don't bother usually. So let's see if I get this wire out. Sometimes they're easy, sometimes it's hard. This one might be a pain. Doesn't wanna, there's no play. Okay, well, we'll cut this one off here. It was a bummer. I was hoping to get my truck started. I knew it might be an issue with the battery, just because I'm having problems with the battery there. Can't see one wire. See the black wire on that side. We could pull the black wire out. We'll have to try to find the other wire on the inside. There it is. There. So the two wires are out. It's not a lot, but you know, it all at the end helps, right? This one, I'm not sure about that one. Goes down somewhere. Let's see. Some more wires here. I had one that was simple. It was just one wire to the bottom. This one is like a little different. But it's a heavier gauge wire. Okay. That's all I could do on that one. And then this one, I'll just take off this thing here. Little mortar. It's actually a wire here. I can pull these two wires off. Let's put the wire for the cord, I think. I'm surprised he never took the cord off. Took all the little wires. There's actually a relay here too I can take. Right here. So I've got my big screwdriver. I tried phoning Scrapyard to get the price on the aluminum, but they never answered. So I'm hoping it's still the same, 35. But if it's 30 cents, I'm not gonna bother because know, 100 pounds is gonna be like 30 bucks, waste of time. Wait till prices get a little better. But the prices could change pretty quick too, it's just as long as we get a sort of trade deal. See there, a little bit of copper. They get a trade deal together, it can spike up pretty quick. And in Mexico, was making a deal about, they had some sort of deal going and they kind of backing out on something, but anyways, see what happens. Okay, I'm gonna have to do this here. I think we get the hot water tank first. Okay, looks pretty good. So we never thought it would fit, huh? Just judging by how it looked. Okay, so I got a big gap up there. What can I throw? All the stuff will go on top, I guess. Vacuums and crap. These are all empty paint cans. They're just... it's only empty, so... no issue. They actually, when the paint companies recycle, they crunch all the cans up, and then all that, you know, all the slurry and stuff, whatever, they take the scrap yard and they just scrap it. You know, just here, just nothing in it. See, it's dried out. It's gotta be recycled. Would have been nice to dump this, but what do you do? There's always some hiccup, right? Something that doesn't pan out. Rebar. Yeah, forget about it. Even a load like this, probably like 2,500 pounds on there. Hard to get weight. Stuff's light stuff. You need the heavy, well, you need the HMS, but I'm not paying enough. So you have to try to separate it as much as possible. Yeah, well, that's kind of how it is. Looks like aluminum. They still throw stuff on here, like small, things I tear apart, right? So I'll keep the bin here until I get my truck, find out what's going on with my big truck. Almost think, like I say, it's something to do with starter. Okay, so that will be done there. So this will be clean. Compact. Sometimes I make a big deal about this stuff here. Okay, it's ready to go. Here. Okay. Okay. At the end. Okay. That's clean. Clean there. It's the exact same pair I had. I already scrapped one I found in the alley. About a month ago I found one. And a month ago, like a month later, I find this one. It's just straightforward. I need my cutters. Okay, clean, there, clean, see that? Okay, this one I need a pair of pliers. Actually, this one I can go like this. Just because I don't have, I don't have any needles. You're supposed to spread them both out, then pull that out. See that, like that. Stripped. Won't take long. This one's got a shaft in here, so this one, it's off weed eater. I'm gonna cut it one side and see what happens. Smells greasy. Okay, so that's heavy steel. Okay, well, all that's coming out already. Not sure what this one is going to come out or not. Should actually cut it just a little longer, but with a pair of or a screwdriver or something, I can get this one out. Not knowing how long this thing is, right? I never take these apart, because it could actually be one long thing, but I'm not really sure. Let's cut it here. It might go completely through. Probably does. It sits through plastic housing. You might have to cut it multiple times. Yeah. Yeah, it probably goes all the way through. So you're not going to get it out completely. Only thing you can do is hammer it down. Just hammer it down for now. You can melt it. They can melt it. Don't pay nothing anyways for the stuff. Someone's making a lot of money on aluminum. Someone's making a lot. Okay, so I think I can take all those and we got some aluminum frames here, but I have to bait on what I'm gonna do about those. Okay, so I think that's about it for now. I'm gonna figure out what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna pull the fridge out next. This is all done for now. Okay. Okay, I actually inspect this mortar in better detail. It's actually his copper. But when I cut it, it just seems so soft. It's definitely copper. So, see there? I open this up. It's like someone dumped left a garbage in there. So there's nothing inside it, just shelving. Anyways. Okay, so got a nice mortar. Let's finish and take this side off too, by the way. Okay. It's this green one. The more you process, the easier it is later. You do your final processing. I think this is aluminum here, but well, it won't be that hard. I'll just take this nut off. It's obviously not that one. It's a really small one, but oh, there it is. Oh, stupid thing. I don't want it so tight. This. Okay. Supposed to be stainless steel, this piece here. Stainless. Knock this off if I can. Let's get my hammer. Okay, so copper, brass. Let's take this to there. Okay, I checked it. It's probably about, I'd say it's about close to 3/4 pound, I don't think. See, mortar here. Mortar. This one here. Actually, that's why I got this thing here. This is perfect for stuff like that. Well, got something at least. Thought it would go out. This held in there pretty good. Okay. It's okay. Throw this in the heavy metal for now. Okay, so my copper bucket barely lifted. So the brass bucket's there. Dirty one off the figure on the spot. Okay, I said I was gonna do that fridge. Still going back and forth doing things. Okay, so just gotta see the timeline right now. Let's get some metal taken today. 3:30. If I could take these mortars and aluminum or something, we'll see. Always do it Saturday too. Which I might do Saturday. Or I might have time Friday. Here's a handle that's cast aluminum. Okay, get that fridge out now. Just going back and forth, basically what I'm doing. I'm kind of cleaning things too. You know how it is, you know, you see something, you want to clean it and move on to the next thing. That's what's happening. Big fridge. Oh, come on. Yeah, I can't get those bolts loose. I'm going to have to cut them on top because there's some sort of exhaust system or something there, or some sort of shield plate. We can't get to it. I had my brother under. He was under on the other side. He threw the bolts out, but couldn't get these bolts out. So, end result is I'm just debating with grinding. Once I grind them, the bolts off, I don't know how I'll put those bolts back there, you know what I'm saying? So, but I might say I'm just going to scrap those bolts, those, and the seat too. Who cares, you know what I'm saying? So, anyways, see the stupid fridge open. Come on, stupid fridge. Had no grip in front there. Have to do is have to go past the lip there. Once I pass that lip, it's okay. Wish I had a sprinter van, that would be ideal with the lift, but they're pretty expensive right now. No money in scrap, so that's a problem. There was good money in scrap, you could get good vehicles, but it was good for a while. A year ago it was okay. I can take a bin and make almost $300. That was nice. You know, try to make $100 in a bin is almost impossible. Where the chair is, I think. Move that chair over. Every time I'm on a scrap here, they try to steal my pails. I gotta count them all the time because they disappear. Every time I go there, I have to take two or three of them. So I gotta really be on top of it because. As a scrapper, you know, you're scrapping so many different things. Clean things, dirty things. But, you know, I may use my van later to do some loads. Like, I was almost tempted to throw the stove away, but... Okay, we'll see, I threw it away. Let's just see what's in there for wire. That's why I hate throwing stuff away, especially when the prices. When it was 8 cents a pound, it wasn't so bad. A little bit of wire, you know, no big deal, right? But no, 3 cents a pound. Sucks. Could be full of cockroaches, who knows? It's clean. It's clean. It was surprising considering it came from that location. It's actually pretty clean. Yeah, nice and clean. So that was good. so I can squeeze stuff in. Okay, so what I'll do is grab when you scrap, you know, you're always non-stop go. There's always something to do. Right, if I dump it the way it is, I'm gonna lose too much money, so I don't like these switches really, they're not that great. Well, I have to cut these off anyways. If they were the brass clips, it's okay. Guys are doing for New Year's. I was thinking of going out somewhere, but don't know what to do for New Year's. That it was melted, so there was some problems with this thing. See, right there, the oven probably is good. That's why they're chucking out, because probably this was melted here, so it lost the connection. So maybe some elements didn't work, or the stove didn't work. Repair costs would be way too much money, so they scrapped it. But they were renovating the home too. I think the guy brought the house for himself. It looks like a contractor because they put a nice blacktop driveway in. Because obviously, you know, he takes pride of his house, right? See, all this wire here. This one's always, I always cut this anyways, so I'm not worried about that. Actually, I'm gonna first cut this off here. No such luck. Okay. That's that. Everything I'm taking off this is a bonus, right? Otherwise, we just left it on there, right? Let's see if I can get this lower plate off. But I think there's stainless steel on the handle here and a few things. Oh, this comes out already. Okay. Okay, it's done. Okay, this is probably aluminum. This little faceplate. You just got a magnet on there. I think it's gonna be aluminum. Let's put this stuff on top. Yeah, not the handle. This oh, it's steel. Okay, so I had it wrong. Must be something else I was looking at. Okay, well, it's probably aluminum. Anyways, pop it off. It's just a sticker. sticker. Almost not worth it, but it's actually got quite the stick to it. Usually it's not that sticky. Actually, I should have just left it together and then pulled this off first. Then I wouldn't be fighting it, you know what I'm saying? I'm just gonna leave it. It's just too much work. Work for so little. I wonder if this is copper in here. Thought it would come off a little bit better, but you know, it's the way things go. When you demonstrate stuff, you gotta fight it. When you do it, when the camera's not rolling, everything goes perfect. It's always like that. So, number two copper. And some brass. I throw this in my wire pile. This thing here. Still that in there. Okay. A little bit out of copper, you know, not a lot, but hey, it was there, right? Okay. Okay, I'm taking this light apart here. I just noticed these shades. Well, not the glass, but this is steel. The shade. This thing is aluminum. I already chucked one in the garbage, so I lost one. I couldn't retrieve it. I tried. So this cast aluminum, see, or could even be better, could be extruded the way it looks. So you have to try to get this off somehow. Looks like a pretty good piece here. Go inside and see if I can pull that off as well. Fourth one, I almost got it and it fell way down there, so I said forget it. Kind of how it goes. Something to hold this on the inside here. This ball buddy here. Okay. I'll hold it so it doesn't turn. This being rusty, it'll be hard to come off. Turning. Let's see if I can knock that straight, that centerpiece down. System. It's pretty simple. Of course, you can't duplicate it. Funny how one was so easy. Well, this one broke actually. Should come out. Let's see. It's probably threaded in there or something. Hmm. We got a plan here. Tools of trade. This will be on barely. We might not get all the aluminum, possibly, we'll see. Pretty heavy. Too bad I lost the other one. Some nice little pieces there. Okay, let's see if I can loosen this part here. Probably not. I mean, I'm sure if I put in a vise like this, which the chisel. There it is. It's actually pretty heavy. Pretty heavy. So, we'll do the next one. I'm tempted to try to fish the next one out if I can, but I don't think I'll be able to. If I'll be in a bathtub, I don't want to be moving a bathtub and all that stuff. This one broke a little different. Okay, let me see if I could actually, since I have the nut exposed, I rip the nut off. Chisels aren't really that sharp. No problem. See guys, it's never impossible. You don't always need grinders or tools. You just got chisels. You need chisels and different things like that, but you know, the way of doing it. This one's kind of fused in there because I smashed it. Okay, that's it on that one. Okay, here's that lighting. I had, what, four light? The ones that just stripped us the main base of it. So I just took the wire, screws out. Look how much wire is in between it. Amazing how much wire there is here. Look at that, that's incredible. I don't understand why they have so much wire. Maybe so you can make it longer. Those hanging things, make it a little longer if you want. By why. Oh my god. How much wire is a stupid little thing like that? It's ground wire here exposed. So I'll cut the ground wire off. My number two buckets. But also, I'm just gonna take these clips. I'll do later, but take the clips off. This is stainless steel, this piece of metal here. You put a magnet on it, it doesn't stick, so. funny how it's got a... Can't tell what that is. Do I have to do my chisel work? Actually, need my glasses. See if I can use my axe. Tell Max maybe. Pretty tough stuff. Stainless steel, but it's tough. Let's try that chisel again. The problem is it's all, if you look at the material, it's not gonna too flexible it seems like, but if you look at the material is it's all rusty really bad. Yeah, no, where to go. Some kind of nut system on here or something. Can't tell what it is. It's kind of like a. It's not really a Torx, but what is it? Let's try this. Not really sure what it is. Like a little tiny flathead, maybe. Let's see if I have something here. Problem, these precision tools, they're hardened when you have a really tight screw. Okay, this one's coming. A really tight screw doesn't want to. Okay, that one came out. They don't want to come out. Or the tip will actually break. This is hardened. One went in, but how come these aren't? Nice. See, they're rusty really bad. Okay, this one's coming. I'm thinking the shaft maybe not fall down now, because that's your... Well, that might be just your adjustment screw. Just for the string here, like the rope. Oh, the rope, it's, yeah, that's what it's for. The wire. It's not going to do nothing. This. Slippery stuff. One's out. Probably good stainless steel. It's almost there. Well, it went right through. I think it's too much. I can grind it if I want. It's just too much of a waste of time, really. But, anyways. That's a problem. It's been sitting in the rain. These things are all rusty. You can see there, the rust is here really bad. I still got the wire anyways, got the main stuff out of there. Okay, let's move on.
Okay, let's see if we get this one out here.
So it's pressed in. These ones are tough.
It was actually easy. Okay. It's actually pretty easy. I thought it'd be tougher than that. That one's out.
Now I gotta deal with these things here. Off a barbecue. Little clips there, they gotta pop out. A lot of weird stuff in this one, actually. I've never seen this type of valve. Big spring in here. Some plastic here of some sort. Never seen this type of valve. I'm not sure. At least take some more stuff off for now. Looks like brass. Yeah, so over here for now. It's got a little fuel jet here. It's gonna come off. Brass. One of my screwdrivers acting kind of weird. Doing that. Try to go really slow, but I got one clean one here. Cast. Okay, brass. It all adds up, you know, a little bit here, a little bit there. Well, definitely not going to get rich or nothing, but something, a little more you can do to get a little more extra money, but either you don't do nothing, just drive around, burn gas, or just kind of putter away with this stuff. Almost gonna go. Everything's so tight in this thing. Hmm. one's got a little, I forget what it's called, kind of clamp there. So, but I just don't understand what's holding this plastic in. It came out easy, actually. Well, that came out. Why did it look so tough? Why did it take so long to get the other one out? Maybe it's just the angle I was trying. Barely got it off. I'm just wondering if I can just pound it out. Give it a little clip. Yeah, better. So, pound it out. Don't worry about the stupid clip. Clean. A little extra. That was one barbecue. I had like about five or six of these on there. Need one that's a little finer. Let's see if that one works. It's worse. Nope. Almost came out. It's actually almost out. Okay, there is clean. Must have been more than one. Just cleaning too many here. Must have been two barbecues or something. It's way too many valves. Okay. Done. Sometimes you bang it, it's enough to loosen it. Got stripped anyways. Let me move on to something else.